Now that we've got the air ride suspension built and we got the truck sitting about how we want, we also got the bed extended here to match the chassis, the next thing that we needed to tackle was the running boards. Now the old original running boards are now too short, but they're also very, very rusty. With those issues combined, we decided to fabricate brand new running boards from scratch. Now there's not much materials, believe it or not, that are required to build these running boards like we've already got started here on this side. Now you need some half inch rod and also some 1x1 steel box tubing. That's basically all we have here, along with a little bit of sheet metal to build the skeleton of this. Now the tools that you're gonna need are also pretty minimal. Now you're gonna need an angle or cutoff grinder, plasma cutter, sawzall, anything like that that's gonna get your pieces cut the size. And the main product you're gonna need, or tool, is gonna be the Eastwood MIG 175. Now this is gonna be the key player in building these running boards. So let's get started by building the outer skeleton with this half inch rod. We're gonna show you a couple tricks on how you can bend this up without having any kind of industrial tools. So let's get started. Now we've got the truck spun around. We got the original passenger running board sitting in front of us. We've also got the half inch rod that we're gonna be using to form the skeleton of the new running board. Now the difficult part of this process is actually bending this half inch rod to match the radius that's on both sides of the running board. Now you may not have the industrial equipment to do so, so we're gonna show you how you can do it at home with some simple tools. Now the first thing is, we're gonna actually mark this about 13 inches in is what we've calculated that we need to recreate this bend on both sides. So I'm gonna mark that real quick. Now when we take this outside, we can make our bends right about where we made those 13 inch marks. And you will find when we're doing the video here, you'll see that the bar is actually too long. Now the reason we did this is it's very difficult to make your bends land at the correct spot without wasting a lot of material. So what we're doing is we're going to make the two bends, then we can cut the bar in half, slide it together so that the radius matches on either side, and the overlapping portion will cut out and just toss away. This is a really simple way to do it without too much overthinking. So let's take the bar outside and we'll show you how we're going to make the bends. Okay, now that we've showed you a really simple way to make the bends on each end of this half inch rod here, let me just show you why we started with a piece that's much longer than we actually need. So you can see here where we started cutting up and actually slid it together to get the radius the same on both ends. Now if you would have started with a piece that was exactly the right length, you would have had to have your measurements dead on, otherwise the running board skeleton is going to be skewed a bit. So this way we can cut it, slide it together, cut off the excess fat, and then we can butt weld everything together. We'll have two identical pieces to make the beginning framework for our new running board. This is a really simple way to do it without too much extra thinking, or for any beginners that aren't too good at doing the measurements when you're doing these bends. So let me get cutting on this piece here, and then we'll butt weld the two of these together, and then we'll come back in the next step and we'll just show you what we're going to do from here. Okay, now that we've shown you how we cut the rods, slid them together, and welded them back together, we got some 1x1 box tubing here that's going to make up the top frame of the new running boards. Now we're using this to strengthen everything up so that you can actually step on the running boards without fear of them caving in. We also have some small 1/4 inch rod here that we're going to use. It's actually going to be the uprights. So we're going to take the other rod that we bent up, put it on top, and then we're going to put this framework also at the top, and that'll make up the running board. So let's show you how we're going to put this together, and you'll see it start taking shape pretty quickly. Okay, now that we've got everything tacked together, you can really see that the framework is really taking shape. So the next thing we're going to need to do is make up some mounts so that we can bolt it to the chassis to check fitment. Once we made sure that everything fits as we'd like, I'm going to finish weld the tubing, then we can start on the skin for the running board. And we'll be using the Eastwood bead roller to both strengthen the top as well as keep some of the original styling, bringing us that much closer to completion. Now that our pile of metal is starting to look like a running board, I've went ahead and made a template that's going to give us an idea of what the top skin of the running board is going to look like in the end. I've also, in the meantime, used the Eastwood electric shear to rough cut out a piece of sheet metal that's going to become the final top for the passenger side running board. Now, if we've made this piece here a bit bigger, about an inch on all sides, than what we're going to actually need. So that way, when we're running some beads with the Eastwood bead roller, we have a little bit of room for error in case any of them go astray. Now I'm going to copy the template onto this piece and we're going to take it over to the other side of the shop where we can begin working the metal. The last couple shots you saw where we were running the real long beads for the top of the running board. Now that we've got them set, we've brought this piece back over to this side of the shop where we actually have the truck sitting, and we've set it down for a test fit. And it's really starting to look like something. In the meantime, I've grabbed a piece of metal here and cut it down to a rough size for what's going to become the face of the running board. So what we're going to do is wrap this piece around and test fit everything, and we're going to shave the two pieces of metal back down so that the front face of the half inch rebar is exposed, and that'll give us a nice radius for the full length of the running board when we're done for the final project. So I'm gonna pull the MIG 175 out, start setting everything down and laying some tacks, and we'll show you what it looks like after we have a couple tacks laid down. With a handful of spot welds laid with the Eastwood MIG 175, we have the skin fitted to the frame, and we decided to pull the truck outside so we can get a nice wide open view of what the new running board looks like attached to the truck. And I really think it's turning out pretty good. So after we're done here, we're gonna finish laying all of our spot welds down, finish grind it all, and then lay some self-etching primer down on the running boards to seal them up until we decide what we're gonna do with the top coat for the whole entire truck. So anybody that's been following along, the tools that we used with the Eastwood MIG 175, the electric shears, the bead roller, and an angle grinder to make new running boards from scratch. Not too many tools at all. And the final supply cost was right around $100. So in the end, the money that you're spending on this project and the tools is gonna far outweigh what you would have spent if you had a custom shop build them for you, or if you bought them aftermarket. So it's really a no-brainer. So I'm gonna finish up with these running boards and stay tuned for more videos where we show you how to save money and build cool projects.